Openshot Video Editor is a useful and simple program to edit short videos. Some videos that you do at home when you play or when you make TikTok videos or YouTube videos, you can use Openshot Video Editor to add titles and intros and exits and everything. It is a freeware, that means you can download it for free, and it is compatible with many different operating systems on your on the computers. But where do you find Openshot Video Editor? Yes, you can download it from YouTube, but if you download the incorrect one, you may have trouble, as I found out a couple of weeks ago that the latest update is full of bugs and it didn't work properly. So most of the computers, if you have Windows installed, you will find an older version that is working perfectly fine and it is free. So if you go to your taskbar, that's a black bar at the bottom of your screen, you will find a magnifying search bar. You click there and you type in VID and it will open up Openshot Video Editor for you there. So you click and you open it up. Depending on the size and the power of your computer, it will take a couple of seconds to open up and you will see the screen in front of you. So, what does it all mean? On top, you have the file edit title, that's a menu with the toolbars on what you can do up there. And in the second bottom here, in the middle, you will find all the project files. So you'll see here at the bottom, you'll find project files, transitions and effects. Every time that you click on one of them, the screen inside there will change to something that you can do. Or if you change the effects, that is something that you can change over there. So at the moment, we are going to stay with project files because we still need to import your video that you have taken beforehand. And you can, whatever you do, you will be able to see here on the right hand side in the video preview on how your video will look like in the end. Then at the bottom you have your different tracks, and you can even add on the plus, you can add more tracks. So that is where you're going to add your videos. If you want to add any more pictures or sound and anything else that you want to add, you will add on different tracks. So we usually start with track one for your first video. So where do I find my video? So first I want you to make your own video. You can either use your cell phone or a video camera, record your own video and save it onto your computer. Then you will click on File, Import Files, and you will go and search in your Windows Explorer for the files where you have saved your video. So I'm just going to find mine quickly, and unfortunately I have a lot, so I'll have to scroll down for my video. And it is, if I remember correctly, this little guy, you click on it and it will import it into this preview video window of yours. To use this video that you've just imported, you click, keep your finger in on the mouse, you drag it in to the bottom of your screen into track one. So let's just leave a space there for the intro as well as the outro in the end. So if you want to delete it, you just click on it and you press delete on your keyboard. So let's just leave it there at the moment. I want to add a title, so in my toolbar, my menu there on top, I click on title and I go to just title, not animated title. Animated title is if you have advanced programs like Blender, you can use it from there. So for now, we're just going to click on title and it will open up a new one. Choose from the templates that you have, that I give you there. Choose one that is nice. I am going to choose the sunset because I'm working with a nice little robot and I want to have this title. So the file name, the title name, so this title name is what you will see here in the project file in the preview. So we are going to delete that and I am going to just type in title. Now my title is CodyBot. That is the name of my robot. So I am going to type in CodyBot. You can change the font. If you click there, you can change the different font. You can choose something that you like. You can play around and find whenever you have something, you can use it. You can make it regular, you can make it bigger. All depend on what you want. So that there's my coloring board. You can choose the different font. You can change the text color and the background color. But usually the one that they give you as part of the template works best, but you are welcome to play around with these settings. Then you click on save. And it will save it to your project file over there. And I want to add another one, a title, but it's not really a title, it's going to be my outro. That means when the video finishes, you want to say thank you or give credits to whoever made the video. So let's just see which one will be a nice one to use. Let's just go for that one, it's fine. So this one I'm going to say the end, and instead of saying the title, we're going to say thank you for watching. But you can type in whatever you like, and my second title, wow, we're slow today. See, I've updated my computer last night and it is now extremely slow for some stupid reason. Thank you for watching, and I'm just going to type in Codibot again over there. But now it is blank and white, it's not really nice, so I am going to just change it. If you don't like something, just click on something else and you change it quickly. That is really as easy as that. The end, and I'm just going to say shortly thank you, and you can write in your own name. By highlight and delete, and I am going to say Codibot. He says thank you. And when you're done, you just click on save. And now you have the end over there. So to start your video, click on title, drag it in to line one or track one. Click on your video, drag it in just after that, and find the end and drag it over there. So if you want to see what is happening, just click on the video preview. You'll see on top is video preview, and click on the green arrow, the play button, and give him time to see what is happening. Currently I did not add any sound, so this will just show you what is happening. So you'll see from the title up to the video, it just jumps over to the next one. So how can we make that one smooth? So if you click on the title and on right click, you go to fade and you say start of the clip or end of the clip. So I'm going to say start of the clip, fade in slow. So when the clip starts, it will come in slowly. And right click again, and I'm also going to say end of clip, fade out slow. And I'm going to do it with all my clips that I added. Start of clip, fade in slow. Now you can choose, do you want it to go fast or slow? That is really up to you. You can even zoom in and do what you want. But at the moment, let's just go on to the next one. Let's just say fade, end of clip, and I say fade out. And I'm also going to, you'll see when you click, when you select something, then it will be highlighted in red. So I'm going to say right click, fade, start of clip, fade in slow, right click, fade, end of clip, fade out slow. So now let's just check, so you just move your cursor a little bit back, click on play again and see what happens. I see now it's going a little bit slower, fades out, and the next one comes in slower. Right, already much better. You can add transitions. So, but this one, I must say, depends on the size of your computer. Sometimes it works well, sometimes it doesn't. So I am going to choose bubbles. Drag and drop it onto the place where you want it to be. So I'm going to start my video with bubbles, but it's a very long bubble, so I'm just going to stick with on that red line. My arrows changes, and I'm going to make him shorter. So let's just check if that works well. So move your cursor a little bit to the back, click on play, and see if your bubbles work. And it's coming slowly before you start with the other one. So I think I can make my bubbles a little bit bigger and spend more time with my bubbles. So always, whenever you want to do something, just change it and always use the play function to check if it works. So I'm going to use my bubbles again on my outro. So what happens here is whenever you add something, when you change it, just drag this blue cursor with a red line and click on the play button to see if your idea works. If it doesn't, you have time to change it to something else. Now on this one, we cannot really see the bubbles. So I'm going to click there and say delete. Let's just go and play and find something else. I'm going to say deform. And we're going to deform that one. Make the bit shorter and see if that is better. Yeah, it's a little bit, there's a little bit more action in there. Just look carefully, but you will see it. So now I have added a title, I've added my video, I've added this ending scene plus transitions between the different settings. But I still don't have any music. So whenever you add something, move your cursor, that means it's this red line and the blue arrow, move it to where you want to add anything else. So my music, I want to start from the beginning, so I move it in there. Go to file, say import files, and go and choose for your music on your computer. Now in my case, it will be on my hard drive, and let's just go for my, and anything else, well, I'm just going to choose one. So whenever you import something, it will show under your project files, and you can just click and drag it to where you want it to be. Now my music is much longer than my video. So you can make it, click and drag it, make it shorter, but just remember you say right click, fade out, so that it doesn't end just promptly. Okay, now we test it and see what happens. So yes, while the video is showing, my music will play at the same time. And you can make it shorter, longer, you can make it loud, you can make it softer. You work with your pictures and your music as you need it to be. When it's time for you to export, when you're done and happy with everything, there in the toolbar you will find a red button. You just click there and you say export. So export video, you give it a name. In my case, we will stay with CodyBot. And you choose where on your computer you want it to be saved. So there should be a place where you have your videos. So if you look under your C drive, there will be videos. So I'm going to double click on videos. And if you have a specific folder that you want to say where you save all your stuff, you can leave it there like I've done with my FreeCAD and my Word documents. But you can also add a new folder and type in your name and use that where you save all your own work. So I'm just going to select folder And you do not have to change anything out here. You just click on say export video and it will start rendering your video so that you have it available. When it is done, it will give you a dialog where you can just double click and check if your video is correct. And that is it for the basic part on how to import a video and how to make a title and an end and how to export it for you.